Is the officer caught on camera in Inkster punching a man repeatedly during a traffic stop?
During the investigation, Inkster decided to fire him, but it turns out he still has a job as a police officer in another city. Fox 2 San Asher live now in the newsroom with the details, Darren.
Yes, we've learned Officer William Melendez, nicknamed RoboCop by his critics, has been hired as a part-time officer in a city that is no stranger to its own cop drama, where tactics have been recently questioned.
It's the damning dashcam video from Inkster Police, which shows Floyd Dent pulled out of his car, punched and kicked by multiple police officers, one after another. Officer William Melendez, who is clearly shown throwing most of the punches, was fired from Inkster Police last week. But he doesn't have to worry about getting a new job. We've learned he already has one with the Highland Park Police Department.
Did you know about this video when you hired him?
No, this video is the video from January. He's been with us a long time before this actually happened.
Highland Park City Attorney Todd Perkins claims the police department hired Melendez as a part-time officer more than 2 years before this violent video surfaced. Melendez has been on patrol and has now rotated to desk duty. Because he hasn't done anything wrong, Perkins says Highland Park has no reason to get rid of him.
Has he had any problems on the force?
Not that I recall. He's not been proven to be guilty of anything. I know that what it looks like on the video, and we have to accept that. What's this ostensible evidence or this objective evidence?
I wonder what kind of insurance policy they have at Highland Park that would allow RoboCop to go rogue again there.
Greg Roll, who represents Floyd Dent, the man battered and bloody in this video, is flabbergasted that another police department would ever hire the embattled officer who is still being investigated by the FBI and Michigan State Police.
I'm very concerned. I think everyone would be concerned because at this juncture, he's already been fired from Detroit, he's been fired from Inkster, and both times because of some egregious conduct. So I don't know how Highland Park, how desperate they are for officers, but it seems to me they could do a lot better.
This is not the first time officer tactics have been questioned and offered cause for concern. Last January, Highland Park police officer Ronald Dupuy was caught on cell phone video hitting and kicking a carjacking suspect who was already contained and cuffed. The same police department Melendez is now part of.
How concerned are you that this might impact the perception of the Highland Park Police Department?
Well, you're always concerned about perception because sometimes people say perception is reality.
And Dupuy is still under investigation, as we mentioned, so was Melendez. And this is an interesting development. Today, the judge gave the Inkster Police Department 24 hours to produce the rest of that dash cam video. Roll says they only got 5 minutes, an edited version. He's now waiting for the other 15 minutes. Huell?
And what we've seen so far is disturbing. Does he have any idea what's on the rest of that video?
Well, Roll believes it will reveal some very racially insensitive gestures and remarks. He tells us he's hoping to get his hands on it tomorrow, and certainly so are we.
Absolutely. Tamara, thank you.